people. I'm Aisha and you're joining me for some more heavy petting. Today I'm on my way to meet some people who've learned the art of nurturing and letting go. It's one of the greatest lessons that humanity can teach. Take a look at what's coming up on the show and then come right back.
Wildlife. Your pet needs you. Say trees. The dog answers. And go on hospitality.
People for Animals is one of the most well-known animal help groups in the country. Not only do they give shelter to wild animals, but also rehabilitate them and then reinstate them into the wild when the time is right. In effect, they help wild animals with the most minimum possible human encroachment. Today I'm at PFA in Bengaluru to meet the man who heads their rescues.
Hello, welcome. I'm
going to be okay. How are you?
I'm fine.
It is so lovely here. It's like a little
nook
of
thank
the
you.
Woods.
Yeah. So it's a segregated forest here.
Right.
This land was completely open.
Mm-hmm. So Kishan, what is the kind of work that PFA Bangalore does?
Well, it's mainly a wildlife hospital for suburban life.
Suburban meaning?
Suburban wildlife. I mean, you know, see like birds, all wild birds.
Mm-hmm.
I mean to say not big, bigger kind of wildlife like elephants,
right.
Lions, tigers.
Right. Okay.
Yeah.
So not pets and not the animal kingdom, everything in between.
Yes.
So what is the procedure? How do you get your animals? How does it operate? Where do you catch them?
No, see, anybody, any people in Bangalore, public, they give, they inform us over phone or we have our helplines.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they inform us, you know, they happen to see some wildlife in distress, displaced,
right.
Injured.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they'll call us on our helpline. Then we receive those calls, we attend personally.
Okay.
We, if possible, we apply some first aid over there.
Right.
And then we can get into here.
Okay.
We'll carry on a process of medication, rehabilitation, and again, in the ultimately, release in the wild.
Which is actually the crux of People for Animals, right? You're not aiming to domesticate any of these animals.
Yes.
You're just healing them and then releasing
them. That's it. Yeah. Yeah.
And what is the number of animals that pass through PFA, say, in a month? What is the quantum of work?
No, in a month, averagely 100 to 110 animals are rescued.
Wow.
But you know, our success rate is only 35 to 40%,
mm-hmm.
limited to our sources.
By success rate, you mean animals that are reinstated into the wild successfully?
Yes, because you know, people happen to see, you know, the information when we get it will be too late.
Well, and that's where we come in. So at least now you know which numbers to call and that process can be expedited.
Oh, fine.
What is the number of employees, like what is your workforce comprised of?
We are about 10 people.
You have 10 people and about 100 animals pass through here?
Yes.
Every month?
Yes.
How does that work?
Yeah, it's a tough job. 10 rescues a day.
Yeah.
Or once we don't get any rescue calls.
Okay.
So that's how we plan our schedule.
And what about volunteers? Do you have volunteers from the city,
yeah,
young people?
See, our active volunteers are young and energetic college students.
Mm-hmm.
And they do find time. They have time to contribute. Their time to, take part in this kind of activities. They have to go to far places where we have advised them to attend the calls.
Right.
You know, they go there, they attend there,
mm-hmm.
and they have to bring the animal here.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a tough process.